Hello, my dear students. Let us solve some more examples on Buzyniec and Westergaard analysis. Yesterday, I have done this example using Buzyniec analysis. Today, let us discuss, let us solve this problem using Westergaard analysis. Okay. So here, the inner radius is given, that is diameter is 7.5 meters. So inner radius is 3.75, and outer the diameter is given 10 meters, so the radius is 5 meter. So Westergaard's analysis, for that this is the formula: sigma z is equal to q into 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus a divided by nu z whole square to the power half. Okay, here this all of you know now. Yesterday also I considered same thing. A is equal to r naught or ri, for r naught is for outer radius and ri is for inner radius. Okay, so now this I have solved, shown here in the last video only, that is r I divided by z is equal to 0.9375 and r naught divided by z is equal to 1.25. Okay, now we have to calculate what is nu here. The nu is equal to square root of 1 minus 2 mu divided by 2 into 1 minus mu. This is the formula to find nu. Okay, so here when you substitute in this equation mu, what is mu here? It is given mu is equal to 0. So when you substitute mu is equal to 0, this term 1 divided by 2, here mu is 0, 1 divided by 2, that is square root of 1 divided by 2. Okay, now we'll substitute the values in this equation. Q is equal to 160 into 1 minus bracket start 1 divided by 1 plus, this is 2. How this is 2? Because see, 1 by nu is 1 by 2, correct? So that is nu is equal to 1 by 2. Now we required 1 by n, so that is equal to 2. You understood? Nu is equal to square root of half. Okay, but in the formula it says 1 by nu whole square, so the square root get cancelled because it is whole square. So 1 by 2, when you square it, it becomes 1 by 2, but that is nu. We want 1 by nu, so nu is equal to 2. Okay, 2 into a by z ratio, that is nothing but for the inner outer radius, it is r naught by z, that is 1.25 whole square, because a by z whole square, minus inner diameter radius or inner radius you have to consider. So what is that? 160 into 1 minus here this. Again, in this formula, 1 by nu, that is equal to 2 into, this is related to this a divided by z. Here it is related to inner radius. So, ri divided by z, that is equal to 0.9375. So, simplify this, you get 17.57 kilonewton per meter square. So, using Buzyniec equation, the value is 23.11 kilonewton per meter square. But when you find using Westergaard analysis, you will get 17.57 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, let us take one more example. Calculate the intensity of vertical stress induced at a 0.2 meter vertically below the corner of a square footing of 2 meter side, transmitting a bearing pressure of 12 ton per meter square to the surface of the soil deposit. Use the Buzyniec equation. So here it is asked to find the vertical stress at a 0.2 meter vertically below the corner of a square footing. Okay, we don't have the exact formula to find the square footing, but we have the formula to find vertical stress under the corner of a rectangular area. that is given by this equation. All of you know now, this is the equation to find the vertical stress under the corner of a rectangular area. But what you can do, here it is a rectangular, so this formula can be applied to square also. So how you will get, so that M you have to find, M is equal to A by Z ratio. Here A is square footing, it is 2 meter wide, so that is 2 divided by what is Z? Z you have to calculate at a point 2 meter vertically below the corner, so Z is equal to 2. Okay, so M is equal to 2 divided by 2, that is equal to 1. And N is equal to what? B divided by Z. Here it is a square footing, so B is also equal to 2 only. So 2 divided by 2, again it is equal to 1. So now we have what is M and N value. You can substitute in this equation. Okay, so what is that? Sigma Z is equal to Q is equal to 12 ton per meter square. You can keep the same thing, no need to change the unit. So it is 12 only, Q divided by 4 into pi into 2 into mn, m is 1 and n is also 1, and again m square, n square plus 1, 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 to the power half, then divided by this formula. Everywhere it is 1 only, because m is equal to 1, n is equal to 1. So simplify this, you get 2.1027 ton per meter square. Okay, like this you can calculate vertical stress for a square footing. You can use the same formula of rectangular footing. Let us take one more example. A concentrated load of 800 kN acts at the ground surface. Compute the vertical stress at 8 meter depth. First case in the axis of the load, and second case is 2 meter away from the axis. Use Westergaard analysis. So here mu is equal to 0.25. In the previous problem, whatever I have solved, there I have taken mu is equal to 0, but in this case mu is given, so you have to substitute mu value in this equation. Okay, if it is not given, you directly take it as 0. Now it is asked to calculate by Westergaard analysis. So there are two cases. The first case is in the axis of the load. So in the axis of the load means there is no radial distance, so r equal to 0. Okay, the first case r equal to 0 and z is equal to 8 meter depth. Okay, then in the second case r is equal to 2 meter and z is equal to 8 meter. So direct substitution in this formula, this is for Westergaard analysis. Sigma z is equal to q divided by 2 pi nu square z square into 1 divided by 1 plus r divided by nu z square to the power 3 by 2. So q is equal to 800 divided by 2 pi into nu. So substitute mu value in this equation. So 1 minus 2 into 0.25 divided by 2 into 1 minus 0.25. Take the square root, you get 0.577. So substitute in this equation and z is equal to here 8. Okay, 8 square. So into in this equation. So here r equal to 0, so this whole term becomes 0. Okay, so 1 divided by 1 plus 0 to the power 3 by 2. So you'll get 5.97 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, let us take the next case, that is z is equal to 8 meter and r is equal to 2 meter. So direct substitution, substitute here mu is same 0.577 and z is equal to 8. So 8 square into 1 divided by similarly use this equation, mu is 0.577 and z is equal to 8. Okay, here r is equal to 2. So you get 4.62 kilonewton per meter square. So very simple direct substitution. Okay, let us take this Newmark's influence chart problem. See here, a rectangular area 2 meter by 4 meter carries a uniform load of 80 kilonewton per meter square at the ground surface. Find the vertical pressures at 5 meter below the center and corner of the loaded area. Solve using Newmark's inference chart. Similar problem I have solved using Buzinesque also, Westergaard also. Now let us calculate this vertical stress value using Newmark's inference chart. So Newmark's inference chart, I have told to refer the IS code. This is the Newmark's inference chart. Okay, so there will be 20 circles, radial circles, and here there are two cases. One case, first case you have to calculate at the center, and next case you have to calculate at the corner. Okay, so first case, what you have to do here, you have to consider the sum scale. Okay, so here in this problem, it is given in this chart, AB is equal to 5 centimeter. Okay, so here it is asked to find the vertical pressure at 5 meter below the center and corner of the loaded area. So what you have to consider, the always the vertical depth that you have to consider. So 5 centimeter is equal to 5 meter. Okay, so 1 centimeter equal to 1 meter. Okay, remember this, always you have to convert the scale. Okay, so here it will be given in meters, so you have to convert into centimeter, because this line AB, that is equal to 5 centimeter. So now it is asked to find at that particular depth, so that dimension you have to consider always. So now AB, the depth is 5 meter, so 5 centimeter is equal to 5 meter, so 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. Now you have to draw the rectangular area, okay, on a trace paper. Okay, then place that tracing paper on the chart exactly at the center, means center of the plan, and that means on the tracing paper, and the Newmark's chart should coincide. Okay, like this. So suppose this is one rectangle I have put here of dimension 2 meter by 4 meter, means I have drawn for a scale of 2 centimeter by 4 centimeter. This is 2 centimeter and this is 4 centimeter, and placed on the this inference chart, okay, exactly at the center. Don't consider this rectangle. Now only consider this rectangle. Okay, so exactly at the center of the rectangle should coincide with the Newmark's chart center. Now what is the formula says, that is number of area vertical stress under the center of the area is equal to, this is the formula, 0.005 into Q into Na. We have Q value, we know 0.005, so we have to calculate this Na, that is number of area units under the rectangle. Okay, so see here, count this, consider this rectangle. Okay, so how many full areas are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like that you have to consider. This is doesn't give the exact number, because this is zoomed, so you may get the wrong result also. So what you do, you take one paper and draw that plan, and code you will get this chart. So place that rectangular plan on the chart and count that. The way of method of counting is like this: full area, if it is full, then consider it as a full. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So suppose here only half, only 1/4 is there. So you just consider that is 0.25, like that. Okay. Suppose now see here, it is not exactly full, so but it is almost full, so you can consider 0.75, like that. You have to count. When it was counted, I got this value, Na is equal to 25.5. You just see and check whether you are getting the same number of area units. Okay, once if you get that, directly substitute in this equation, you get 10.2 kilonewton per meter square. This is first case, that is under below the center. Now you have to calculate for the corner of the loaded area. Again, same thing, you have to place that rectangular area on this chart. But how? Now the corner has to be placed at the center. Okay, you can see here, this is a rectangle of size 2 meter by 4 meter, and place this, and you get here what you have to do. This corner of the rectangular has to be placed at the center of the Newmark's influence chart. Okay, like this. This is for the second case. Okay, don't consider this rectangle now, that is for the previous one. So place this rectangle like this. Okay, the corner should be placed over the center of the chart. Now count how many numbers. Okay, so suppose if you are starting from here, don't consider this inner circle. Okay, consider from here. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 okay, 8 9 10 11 12 13 14, like that. Consider if there are how many are full and how many half, and suppose 25%, 75%, add everything. Finally you get 18.5 areas units you will get. So how to find the vertical stress? Vertical stress is equal to 0.005 into Q into Na. Q is equal to 80 and Na is equal to 18.5. So you get 7.4 kilonewton per meter square. So I hope all of you understood. Just try on a tracing paper and see the answers. Thank you.